one hand steering.
Yeah, man. He's cool. I'm cool. I see Cobra.
Good job. Is that fun, Riley? She's got a Rambo headband on the way she's wearing it. I just got these. They are wooden fruit and veggie magnets from Mud Puppy, and Riley loves them. I got them because ever since Duncan booked these trips to Spain and Northern Ireland, Belfast we're going to, I've been wanting like toys that I can kind of travel with that hold her attention, and she's really been liking things like stickers, so I've gotten her some sticker books to travel with. And that just got me thinking along the lines of magnets are kind of like really reusable stickers, like forever reusable. And she's always liked playing with magnets, and it only just came to my mind to get her magnets for her to play with. So thought we'd do fruits and veggies for some word recognition for her. And what I'll do is when we travel, I'll just bring like a few of them instead of all of them for her to play with. I think she loves them. She's been doing this already for quite a few minutes, and we literally just got them, so this was a really good buy. I'm very happy.
I just had a major filming error. What's the word? Producer? Director? I just filmed Roo falling asleep in the tricycle on the way home, but then it turns out there's only 4 seconds of it. Because that was when I pressed end and it started recording. So we missed it all. So now you've just got me eating cake while the girls are upstairs in bed. Roo's sleeping. Yeah, sorry. My bad. She looked really cute nodding off in the tricycle thing. Sorry. Do we do goodnight anymore? No, we don't. See you tomorrow.
You ready to go to playgroup, Riley? Come on, let's go. Dunks is sporting the short shorts.
Classy, huh? Gonna get some wolf whistles today.
I've got Riley sat there watching the Teletubbies because I just did a diaper, which I'm gonna tell you guys about in a second. But before I get into that, I just wanted to say that lately I've been thinking Riley is showing lots of signs of being ready to start potty training. And one of the big things is in the past, I wouldn't even know when she was pooing. We would just have to smell or visually check her diaper constantly to know if she's pooed, because her poo would come out so easily and so soft that she wouldn't really show any signs that it was coming out. She didn't seem super aware of her pooing. So lately, like the past few weeks, it's been very obvious when she's pooing, and a result of that is as soon as she poos, I know it, because like I can see her when she's doing it, so I can change her diaper immediately, which has been great, because she doesn't have to sit in her poo. And the result of that is now when she's pooing, she'll actually like walk over to the couch and like kind of sit there and wait for me to change her poo. Change her diaper. So, and she knows how to pee on the potty. Although she doesn't always pee on the potty, she will just happily pee on the floor if you leave her nappy free. Hi, monkey. You want to say hello to everybody? So anyway, about this nappy change today. Because she's been teething so badly and having her molars coming in, Riley, bless you, Riley always has a problem where she produces a lot of, you want booby. She produces a lot of extra saliva, and it irritates her, it gives her a lot of gas, and one of the other things it does is it gives her poos that give her a nappy rash. And it's just consistently always happened every time she has teeth coming in. So, hope you guys can't see anything. Let me raise the camera a little bit. The reason I haven't started potty training her yet, even though I'm thinking about starting it soon, is at the moment she has a nappy rash and she scratches at it if she doesn't have a nappy on. So I always have to put the nappy on her as soon as possible. And one of the things that she's been doing instead of scratching it with her hands is she will just climb onto my leg and kind of grind against my leg to scratch, which is like annoying, especially because a lot of times I'm changing her nappy and she will grind on me before I even get a chance to wipe her up, which is no big deal when it's a pee. Well, today she just did that after she pooed, before I got a chance to wipe her. So I caught the poo right away. There wasn't much poo attached to her butt. It was just at the exit hole. TMI, right? TMI. But the reason I hadn't wiped right away, I literally gave it 2 seconds. The reason I gave it 2 seconds, though, is because she looked like maybe she wasn't finished. So I wanted to make sure she was finished before I, you know, got in the way. Because, you know, I didn't want to interrupt it. Next time, I'm just going to, like, interrupt it if I think it's still coming. Because she took matters into her own hand and wiped it all over my leg. Riley's making music. Crazy masses. All fighting over the markdown food.
Look at that.
5 peas. Organic broccoli. Is gonna go for a run. Doesn't he look jazzy?
So coordinated.
My job is to keep the baby asleep. I might go get some chips and a coffee. I'm not sure how good the microphone is gonna pick up, but can you guys hear all the birds in the background? It's really pretty, isn't it? I'm just rocking the baby to the sounds of birds. Guess what, guys? It is pizza party Friday night, and Daddy made the pizza. How good does that look? Not only did Daddy make the pizza, but it is a quinoa crust. He used the recipe that Megan Elizabeth posted a little while back. If I remember, I'll link it down below. There's a good chance I might forget. If anybody's interested and you want the link and you can't find it, let me know and I'll put it down below if I forget. But also on this pizza, Tesco's own brand is, they've redone their fake cheese, vegan cheese range, and they are so freaking good. So this stuff is so freaking creamy. It reminds me of the Mikio's, that I had back in the US. Really, really, really good. And I've had their Parmesan. Really, really freaking good. And I have had their Red Leicester slices for the first time today. really, really freaking good. These are actually the best vegan cheeses I've ever had in my life. And before that, in England, the best I could get, you guys all know I've liked those Violife ones. These blow the Violife out of the water. Because these actually taste like real, real cheese. And as you can see, they melt really well. And even Dunks agreed. It's really creamy, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
He says it reminds him of goat cheese, but I think that's like the texture, like the super creaminess. Mm. It is really, really creamy. So, win, win, win. That Red Leicester is like super, it's got like a little bit of a sharp taste to it. It's really, really good.
And if you're saying it's the best cheese ever, she's a cheese expert.
Yeah, well, part of the thing as well is they really hit all the senses because the smells are super cheesy. Like,
yeah, the whole car smells of Red Leicester now.
Yeah, because we had it in the car because I was giving little bits to Riley, and it's really a strong cheesy smell, and like the flavor is very cheesy as well, but like getting the smell right as well really helps the whole experience. And I never considered myself a cheese lover in the past, but these are really, really spot on. So if you're in the UK, you have to try these new cheeses from Tesco. They're freaking delicious. Should I have to even say that I am so clearly not sponsored?
No, not by the evil empire.
But hey, send me some free cheese, please.
We don't endorse Tesco.
We're in the car. Dunks just got some cash. Why?
Because we're off to Leicester for some cake.
We're going to another vegan fair festival. There's like one every single weekend in England these days. Because veganism is so cool and in. But I wanted to show you guys. I've just given Riley these blocks. They come in this little pouch, which is quite nice. They're this brand Tegu, but they're magnetic blocks, so they stick together. I bought these. This was another little toy that I bought her for traveling, like car rides, plane rides. Because it's small, it's compact, and obviously with the magnets it helps because they hold together, so it's harder to lose. And she really, really likes them. She's like really impressed with them sticking together. So I'm gonna try to keep these as just a car ride and plane toy and not let her play with them in the house, just so they remain special. But I'm really glad that she likes them because I need as many tricks up my sleeve as I possibly can these coming days, because it seems like we've got quite a few longer car rides coming up, and ferry ride, plane ride, lots of stuff. So I'm very happy. Oh, she looks like she's gonna fall asleep, but maybe not. She's like, no, I'm not. No, I'm not. I'm gonna eat them. Moved on to stickers. Yeah, monkey. Stickers and coloring. Bought me the biggest double-decker frosting stuffed cookie ever.
Apparently you don't know I'm running tomorrow, the London Marathon. I've not got off to a good start because I just stuck my number on 31632, but it's on backwards.
Ta-da! Problem all fixed!
It's not on the back anymore.
Nope. And what's Daddy drinking?
Reishi tea elixir.
To thing. Sleep better at night.
We need it.
Yeah.
It's bedtime.
Somebody's asking for boob, even though she was just on my boob.
She's looking at me a bit funny because I don't wear this very often. It's a bit skimpy, isn't it? These aren't my running shorts, by the way. These are my pajamas.
Yeah, your running shorts are shorter.
Sure. Morning. Wind a big smoke. I am looking very trendy in my gear I'm going to throw away for the run. Oh look, there's a Manning Silver. Must be a runner. I'm just waiting for Stouty to poo. I'm going to take my chances in the Portaloos. Love a bit of poo talk. Yeah, we're nearly there. Just got to get on one more train and then we're at the start almost, so bang on time.
I've just been standing in the middle of the road.
Yeah.
And noise from both sides.
Psycho Stouty. He's ready to go. Just done the business. Don't know where Stouty's gone, I think he's deserted me. Strip on. Here we go.
Guys, 007.
We have a task! Louisa!
Busby! Hello, Busby!
We like Busby, he's a cool guy.
Can you say good morning, guys? We're doing puzzles while Daddy runs a marathon. Well, I'm just putting the piece where it goes, and then Riley's putting it down. Next one? Can you do that one, Riley? You like to help Mama? Oh, good job, Riley. You did it. Give me 5. Good girl. We're doing some more diaper free time, so she's just got some panties on under there. That's why we're hanging out in the kitchen, where she can pee on the floor and it's easily wiped up rather than the carpet. I've got a unicorn staring at me. That's a bit creepy. I'm playing with your magnets. Magnet. What's this one, Riley? Riley, what's this one? Orange. It's really a grapefruit, but she doesn't know that. What's that one? What's this one? Banana. She always forgets where the syllables go in banana. You want a banana? You want me to get you a banana? Want a banana? Say banana. Say banana.
Good. Race is over. 2K to go. Hamstring is gone. Can't run anymore. Except I'm still running. We'll make it soon. I hate running. Sort of changed. Official 3:08:24 time. So We had a few muscle issues of about 4 or 5k to go. Hamstring kind of snapped off. Legs are pretty much trashed. I'm walking like a... Well, I'm hardly walking, man. Now I'm off to Whole Foods and Chipotle and some vegan ice cream to celebrate. And then home. Check this out. Matcha, raspberry, waffles, passion fruit. It's my little treat. All vegan. Gluten free, dairy free, soy free. Not a lot in it really. See that? Chipotle. For the whiffy. And me. Gotta eat. We got. Can you see in there? 3 burritos. Veggie vegan.
What does the piggy say, Riley? What does the piggy say? Oink, 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 oink. You're right. Oink, oink, oink. Good girl. Meow. Good job. That's the kitty cat. Oink, oink. What's the kitty, what's the piggy say? You didn't do the face that time. Oh, yeah. Good job. What does the doggy say? What does the cow say? What does the cow say? Off to the next. Say on to the next, Mom. I'm over it. Now, we never did a vegan fair from Lester Hall after yesterday. But we've got 2 different types of baklava. We've got a Victoria sponge with raspberry jam in it.
Stale.
And we've got a lemon drizzle with Duncan's hair on it.
Really?
And I know what you're all thinking.
Extra protein.
You're all thinking that is a lot of sweets and cake for 2 people. Or maybe even 3 people because, you know, Riley's here too. And there's only 1 thing I have to say in response to that.
It's all mine.
It's a lot for 2 people, but it's not even for 2 people. This is 100% for Dunks.
This is what happens when you run a marathon. You can afford to indulge.
I did have a piece of Victoria sponge, but I have not had anything else.
It's rock hard.
For the record. This we know is good, because mm-hmm. We've had this before. This is from Flo's Kitchen.
I'm starting with a worse one.
This I just kind of bought last minute because I felt bad for the guy. He swindled me. It was the end of the fair and he still had cake and he was like, I don't want to go home with it.
So he gave it to you for free?
No. Paid £5 for 3 slices.
A stale cake.
How much did you pay for that baklava? Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, keep it moving now.
£3 a slice.
Riley's
not bad.
Riley's eating her 3rd box of raisins at the moment.
She's trying to be tidy, look. Oh, look, show my t-shirt.
Got it licked. That's why you went for ice cream afterwards, right?
Weird. Coincidence.
Anyway, actually, no, that's not the end of the vlog. What was your official time?
3:24. In the video, it will show you do it. 3:10 on the thing, but I was like 2 minutes behind.
Obviously, he didn't start at the exact start of the race because it's when you go through the thing. But yeah, so 3:08:24, which is a very good time, except And it is a very, very good time. Except Duncan's goal was sub 3:05. So he only missed it by 3 minutes and 24 seconds. And the reason why it sucks is you need a sub 3:05 to qualify for next year's marathon. Mm-hmm. So at the moment, he's not qualified for next year's marathon. He won't be running it. But he says he can run it if he does a sub 3:05 in another marathon that is run by... I don't know if you guys can hear me with Riley screaming in the background.
Sorry, emotions, everyone.
But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. And I'll see you next week. Bye!
I won't. I'll be dead from cake.
You'll just be passed out on the couch. Can you say goodbye, Riley? Bye. This is our ghetto way of covering corners on the table because Riley keeps hitting it. You said bye, good girl. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye-bye. Click.